Running an online challenge is a great way to grow your email list or to launch a new product or offering. I've done a few different challenges over the last 2 years, so I wanted to share how I set mine up so you can do the same. If you're new here, my name's Jess and I help business owners save time and look good online. And today I'm going to walk you through the back end kind of setup of running a free online challenge. You can charge for a challenge if you want also, but today's really going to be about running a free one. So the first two things that you need to think about are what your challenge is going to be about and how long it's going to be. So I recommend that your challenge be very specific. Like a challenge about how to grow your business is way too broad versus a challenge on getting, you know, your first 100 email subscribers or something like that would be a lot more actionable. What's really key is that your challenge is directly related to your program, course, offering, whatever you're going to be launching at the end of the challenge. You don't want to do a challenge around email list and then have a course about Instagram. And then when it comes to how long your challenge should be, I recommend 4 to 5 days max. Some people will do up to 7 days, but you would have to have a really engaged audience, I think, and the challenge be really, really super simple to do. Once you've figured out the details, then it's time to start marketing it. So come up with a clear, concise name. If it can be catchy too, that's great, but don't come up with some vague name that people are like, "What is the belief challenge?" I recommend starting to promote it 2 weeks before it kicks off. If you wanted, you could stretch it to 3 weeks out, but I would recommend that first week really just be kind of teasing it and then really ramp up your promotions the first 2 weeks right before your challenge. Based on my own experience, this is not official data, but I get up most of my signups the day I announce it and maybe the day after, and then the day right before the challenge kicks off. Those 10 to 12 days in between, the leads kind of trickle in. Now, when you're marketing your challenge, you want to send people to a specific landing page. Personally, I do very short landing pages where it's like title, one or two sentences telling you what it's about, and maybe the week that it's happening, and here's where you put your email address. I would also make sure that your URL is very short and succinct. If you can, just have like yourdomain.com/challenge. And then there's the actual running of the challenge. And there's a lot of different ways you can set this up. Personally, I do mine in a Facebook group where I go live each day of the challenge and just do a live training. But I've also been a part of challenges where you just get an email prompt every day, or you get an email prompt with a pre-recorded video that's on YouTube. And then on the last day of the challenge, that's when I launch or announce my offer. And then for the next 5 to 7 days, I will send all the challenge participants emails, basically selling and continuing to pitch my offer. If you're curious again about all the tech that I use, it's probably a Google Doc for my brain dump and outline, ConvertKit for my landing page and opt-in form, and then Facebook because of a Facebook group and, you know, going live in the Facebook group. I'm sure you have other questions about running challenges in your own business, so let me know down in the comments what you want to know. Be sure and check out these other videos, and I will see y'all next time.